Good evening and welcome to the 13th day of Turning Point online series, which is initiated to inspire during the challenging times that we are going through. This world demands the qualities of youth, not a time of life, but a state of mind, a temper of the will, a quality of imagination, a predominance of courage over timidity, of the appetite of adventure over the love of ease, quoted Robert Kennedy. Today, as the 13th day speaker, we have with us a boy, a young dancer, a male dancer, whom I met in the year 1997, 98. Ever since many years, it's my passion to identify young talents and inspire them with the little things that I know or with my words. In the search for this excellence and talent, we had organized the Natya Shastra dance competitions round Karnataka. And the competition was held in Hubli, or if I remember, Belgaum. And the winner of this competition, Natya Shastra dance competition, was this boy, young boy, in whom I saw a spark, in whom I saw a passion, in whom I said, this boy can make a difference. And I called him up after the competition when he came to take the prizes and told him, I think you should come to Bangalore. And I'm sure it's going to make a difference. And after many years, he did come, and he is the speaker of today, Parshvanath Upadhyay. I welcome Parshvanath Upadhyay.
A versatile Indian classical dancer, Natya Mayura awardee, Parshvanath Upadhyay has carved out a niche for himself today as one of the most sought-after male dancers in India. Winner of several national awards, including Sangeet Natak Academy's Bhismila Khan Yuva Puraskar, Aditya Vikram Birla Kalakiran Puraskar, Ram Gopal Best Male Award, and several others, Parshvanath's prowess in the field of dance is manifold and extensive. Currently, he choreographs, directs, produces, and presents his work at national and international venues under Punya Dance Company, Bangalore. He also conducts dance workshops and regular as well as advanced training classes in Bharatanatyam under the banner of his dance school, Upadhyay School of Dance. Some of his notable contributions include DVD Shambho, based on Indian classical dance, which facilitated the dancers across the globe to use the music and choreography as well. Under Punya Dance Company, he has created some of the most critically acclaimed and successful productions to have been showcased in the last decade, namely Punya Krishna, Partha, Hara, Satkati, and Abha. And his upcoming DVD is titled Maye. We welcome Parshvanath Upadhyay.
Thank you so much, Pratiksha. And thank you so much, Vajayati ma'am, for having me.
Welcome, Parshva. It's so nice to have you. I'm sure that all these days we have had wise people sharing things, and now we have a young wise person sharing things. Welcome. So my first question to you. Where exposure to classical dance is relatively less when compared.
Amma, can you repeat your question, because you were okay. Off for something.
Coming from a region like Belgaum, where exposure to classical dance is relatively less when compared to cities like Bangalore, you have managed to create a niche for yourself and one of the most sought after male dancers. I'm sure that you must have had many turning points to reach the position that you have today. Can you share with us two of your turning points that made a difference?
First of all, thank you so much, ma'am, for having me here today. And it's, I know what kind of situation we all are in today. And definitely this is something is definitely going to boost my mood also today after seeing so much of negative news every single day.
It's the internet. I think he'll be back because he's near in a remote area near Belgaum, which is why his internet is a little, the network is a little bad. He will be back. I think he's already back. Yeah.
Okay. I just want to take this moment to pray that we all come out of this pandemic situation we all are in. And to come to your question, ma'am, you are absolutely right. Belgaum being a region which is more enriched, I wouldn't say it is a region which was not classically inclined or people with a less classical approach. It is enriched in Hindustani music of Hindustani classical music of Kirana Gharana and many other art forms like Kathak was fantastically, it was all over Belgaum. But unfortunately, there were hardly any Bharatanatyam dance teachers in Belgaum. And it was, I think, the first turning point of my life was when my guru, Shri Ravindra Sharma sir, came all the way from Mysore and settled down in Belgaum as a dance teacher. He's still working as a dance teacher in Belgaum in a government school. So I think that is number one turning point of my life. And number two, I think me coming to Bangalore to participate in a couple of productions, dance performances, which were choreographed by Padmini Ravanti. That was, I think, the second turning point that I can say, where I was exposed to a new, completely different setup of the art form that I had seen so far.
I think somehow today the internet is, I'm doing a lot of tantrums. But anyway, I also have the set of questions which Amma wanted to ask you.
Great.
So till she comes back, I think I can fill the space. Thanks for sharing with us your turning point. Our next question is, you have learned under three gurus, Guru Ravindra Sharma sir in Belgaum, then with the Kirans in Bangalore, and currently you're also being mentored by Padmashri Professor Sudharani Raghupati ma'am from Chennai. So can you tell us the differences in the teaching methodologies that you have experienced under these gurus? And what have you personally imbibed from each one of them?
All the three teachers of mine have not only influenced me as a dance teachers, but also as wonderful human beings. There are a lot of characters. They have, unknowingly, naturally, we as students follow when we follow them as our idols. Especially with the first guru, Shri Ravindra Sharma sir. He. I think my character of, if I think I have of a giver as a teacher, I just want to give as much as possible. I just want people to learn more and more. I think that is something that I have imbibed by being in close proximity with Sharma sir. I have done my junior, senior Vidwat exam under him and also my Arangetram. I think it was the first Arangetram that happened in Belgaum. So it was like a festival of the district. Everybody had contributed money into it, and it was like a festival for the entire city. And he was somebody who did not take too much of fees from me. He knew I was so interested, and we also came from a very humble background. What he told me after the Arangetram, I still remember, whatever I have to teach you, it is over. I can teach you more and more positions, but I cannot teach you anything more than this. And you are somebody who has to go and learn. I think very few teachers can understand their limitations and want the students to learn more. He was the one who sent me to Bangalore. He was the one who wanted me to learn more and more under the dancers, dance gurus who are performing at the state level and international levels. So I still have very high regards to Sharma sir. And after once I came to Bangalore, with Kiran sir, I still look at him as the most amazing artist, more than a guru. Because I remember so many times I had traveled all the way from Belgaum to Bangalore just to watch his performances, just to watch both of them perform at Kinkini Festival or different dance festivals. His influence as an artist has always stayed on me, his hold on rhythm, that is everybody knows. But also he's so amazing at Abhinaya, very few people know that. Very few people have tapped that talent in Kiran sir, I feel, because according to me, he's the best in Abhinaya when it comes to main way of doing Abhinaya also. And with Sudharani aunty, she understands where I stand right now as an artist, and she's not somebody who is correcting my form or teaching me compositions. She's just helping me expand my knowledge as an artist. She's teaching me compositions, but she knows she is not teaching me the moment vocabularies or choreographies, but she puts in ideas in my mind, I think, which for me as an artist at this age would need the most.
I think each guru has nourished you with things that were important. Can you hear me?
True.
I think each guru has nourished you with things that you required the most at that phase of your journey. But is there something...
And also, I would like to add, Pratiksha, not just three of them. I have learned a little bit and a lot of people. I came to Bangalore. I did not know where to go. I went to Praveen Kumar sir to learn a couple of compositions under him. I went to Bhanumati aunty. She taught me 3-4 compositions. A lot of times I used to come to Bangalore to learn compositions based while still I was student of Sharma sir. That way I have learned under Padmini Rao aunty, Bhanumati aunty. I had a person to learn under a little bit of one composition under two compositions actually under Praveen Kumar sir, and also so many. As a male dancer, I think I am very lucky that a lot of people ask me to come and perform with them, because most of the dance schools have a lot of female dancers and they do not have male dancers. So luckily I had got that opportunity, and because I got this opportunity to perform with different dance companies, different dance schools and different dance gurus, they all influenced me to grow as an artist.
Nice. Yeah. But also, can you tell us a little about how different their teaching methodologies were of your gurus? The three main gurus that you have learned under, how different were their teaching methodologies?
Could you repeat the last line?
Could you tell us the differences in the teaching methodologies of your gurus, of the three gurus whom you have primarily learned?
Sharma sir's class, if I have to recollect how it used to be, it used to go on for 4 hours. So the person who has joined years ago, he would start at 3 o'clock, and his class will go on till his or her class will go on till 7 o'clock. We had to go through the entire hastas, all the there was a format to the dance class which was set, and it was monotonous for every single day. So whether you close your eyes, you know all those theory parts, you know every single thing that was going on in the class. For beginning of 1.5 hours was only theory, then tatadavu, every single class, metadavu, natadavu, all the different beautiful adavus of Mysore Bani, padiyadavu and jaradavu. I miss all those adavus. I try to incorporate them here and there. And all these adavus, yes, we had to do adavus along with those who are still, those who are learning the adavus. Then we do the compositions. Then we learn our new compositions. So basically, we are there from 3 o'clock to 7 o'clock. That was the format of Sharma sir's class. Now with Kiran sir, I would say 1 hour class, he would make us do tatadavu number one. That's it. For 1 hour, and we found out how to find newness in the same thing that we used to do in the class. If we were taught the similar, for example, he would just take one alaripu and try to make it into samatalam, on beat alaripu, and off beat make it into tishram, or many other ways how we can approach it. But when it comes to Sudhanti, she is more of a philosopher. Also, when she takes a composition, she talks a lot about it, and she wants me to come up with my own ideas and choreograph it in my own way. Of course, not the traditional compositions which she has learned under Kittappa Pillai. Ones, whatever the javalis which are meant for female, and she wants me to think and forget that I'm a boy or a girl or anything else as a gender specific, and she wants me to dance to them as a character, as an artist. And whatever 3 to 4 compositions, 3 to 4 varanams that I have learned so far, they were eye opening for me. Because Swami Ninaikori Nanura, I would have never thought I would be able to dance that so comfortably. It is such a Naika Pradhana Varanam, but I cannot wait to again dance it on stage.
Sorry, my internet is going on and off, but as long as Pratiksha, when the internet is there, continue to do so. And Parshva, I heard what you told about it, articulated about the beautiful differences. Can you present glimpses of this for the audience to understand, if possible? The three gurus, something.
Maybe towards the end, Ma, after the questions round, I think we can take.
No,
we can't hear you.
Can we do this now, Pasha, or you prefer to do it later? Now,
I can do it now, ma'am. Yeah. Right now, I think the way I dance, it is a mixture of all these elements. To segregate it, it is going to be very hard for me, but I will still try. With Sharma sir, one composition that is Shabdam, which is my favorite, Ganapati Shabdam. I will do the beginning part of it. Tadaya लंबोदर लक्ष्मी शुभकर अम्बल सुत करुण सागर चक्र है हर ब्रह्म पूजित भक्त जन मंदार भक्त जन मंदार भक्त जन मंदार This is the Shabdam that I had learnt under Sharma sir. Now, with Kiran sir.
Amma, you're muted, ma'am. You're muted.
Maybe the
judging. I always judging... had this, you know. Sorry, ma'am.
No, go ahead.
Yeah, so I will do a jati which is kind of inspired by the jatis that he creates. This is nowhere close to what he can do, but this is just my version of it, I can say. So he uses these beautiful syllables of Ganapati, Ganapa to make the entire jati. Which he had choreographed on me to do Prabhu Ganapati. But this is something that I had taught my students, which I am going to present today. It's in Rupa Kadam. Dhanam Kutakati Kutakatati Kutakam Gam Gam Ganapati Ganapati Gam Gam Ganapati Ganapati Gam Ganapati Gam Ganapati Gam Ganapati 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 Gam Gam Ganapati Ganapati Gam Ganapati Ganapati Gam Ganapati Gam Ganapati 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 Gam Ganapati Gam Ganapati Gam Ganapati Gam Ganapati Gam 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 Ganapati Gam Ganapati Gam Ganapati Gam Ganapati Gam Ganapati Gam 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 Ganapati Gam Ganapati Gam Ganapati
An element of creativity has already come in, you know. It's so nice to see. From then to good.
And with Sudha aunty, this is a very beautiful Sanchari she had taught me in Sami Ninne Kori. It is really difficult to sing this varnam. I'll try my best now. Where the devotee is
my
seeing Lord Shiva everywhere.
You can do something very simple if it's difficult for you to sing and do.
Sure. So here is the devotee who comes to the temple every single day to the Lord Brihadishwar Maha Shivalinga. She or he worships the Shivalinga every single day, and wherever he goes, whatever he does, in every single act he sees Lord Shiva. That is the idea of this sanchari which I will be presenting now. Swami Ninne Kori Namura Swami Ninne
That philosophical, we see it in the dance.
Your voice is breaking, ma'am. Sorry.
What you said about her, that philosophical aspect about her, is seen so much in her through her choreography. Thanks. My next question to you. I'm sure you have been through many dilemmas, discouragement, differences, criticism, and a lot of challenges as well. Can you share with us some of them and how you managed to surpass them and still stand out?
Pratisha, can you help me, please?
Puttu?
Yeah, please, Pash. Because I think your network is breaking in between.
Mine.
Do you want us to repeat? No, Pash, not the network is breaking in between. Do you want us to repeat?
If you could help.
Yeah.
I can't hear, ma'am.
Okay, I'll repeat it. I'll repeat the question. I'm sure in your younger days, you have been through a lot of challenges, like it may be criticism, it can be confusions, discouragement, or dilemma. So can you tell us about some of these challenges that you faced and how you managed to surpass them and stand out with your work? This is network.
Today, it's first time, even last time when we did the series, we had problems on.
No, I think because he is near Chikale, his network is weak. It should be
better. Pashwa, did you hear it?
I could not hear you, ma'am.
Okay. I think you were off.
Do you hear me now?
I can hear you.
Okay.
Yes.
So I'm sure you have gone through many challenges, like discouragement, differences, criticism, dilemmas, and so on. And can you share some of them and how you managed to surpass it and still stand out?
My guru, Ravindra Sharma sir, always helped me and also guided me to break the boundary, break whatever has been taught to you. Don't remember the choreography, come up with something of your own at a very young age, ma'am. So I always had this zeal of choreographing something new. Even in those days when there was no Instagram or Facebook to upload it on, it was just for the sake of choreographing something new. Whether I could perform it or not, that was secondary. But I studied dance for learning dance and not to perform for many years. Because I remember once I came to Bangalore also, for almost 15 years, I was hardly performing. I was learning, yes, of course I was learning. But I was performing very less because I was preparing for competitive exams. And that was my goal, to become an IAS officer or a KAS officer and support my dance with that money, whatever I'm going to get. Now, the fact that till then, I had no idea I can make a career in art. Till then, I had unfortunately, nobody had helped me with this. And whomever I had seen till then had made career out of already very rich, to be very honest. Now, to coming from a middle class family and making a career for you, it was very, very challenging. Financially, I think I struggled until I opened my own dance class. As a performer, I must confess, I struggled a lot. Even though I used to perform more than anybody else, not anywhere I could go and ask before even the performance, because I used to always perform for gurus, I used to always perform for senior artists. I could not go and ask them, how much you are paying me, will your money be enough to support my house rent for this month? I could not ask them that. So I danced because I just wanted to dance. And I think 2010, I decided not to spend more time. I would not say waste. I gained a lot by preparing for competitive exams. I'm a different human being because I studied so much. So I wouldn't call it as waste of time, but I just shifted my priority to dance completely, because until then I did not go for any abroad shows where I could have earned some more money than how much we can do it in India. And from 2010 onwards, I have established my own dance school, and that is supporting me financially, which makes things easier, and I can create something just for the sake of art. So to concise everything, it is important that we think about the financial stability. Irrespective, I mean, yes, it can be through the art, I can be connected to the art. For me, I might not be earning my livelihood as a performer. Dance teacher, yes, I do. If not dance teacher, I would have definitely made a livelihood for myself as a light designer maybe, or as a sound engineer related to dance. Again, or a makeup artist related to dance, a costume designer related to dance. But I knew that I would do something related to dance, whether I danced or not. But I always knew I want to keep on performing. And I just did not know back then how I can make livelihood through performance. I still don't think I know.
I think most of us artists, we don't know, because we are madly in love with dance. Initially, you had a team of like-minded dancers. You hear me?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
You had a team of like-minded dancers, and you all came together. You managed to come out with a lot of productions, which was very well appreciated by the dance community. What are the pros and cons of a group of young dancers working together under one banner in the absence of a guru?
I think I was lucky enough to have worked with these amazing artists who are my friends, and it worked really well because they all respected me, and they knew maybe few years, but I was their senior and I knew a little bit more than them. They were all amazing choreographers, but all they believed was it is better we stick to listening to one person. It is just like having an Indian cricket team. It is Okay, we have Captain Kohli as the captain who leads the team. It does not make other team players any lesser, but it is just an arrangement where you listen to one person to avoid the confusion. Pros, yes, definitely we kept on coming up with many different ideas. Cons, I must say, when you have so many ideas, too many cooks, sometimes it becomes problematic. But luckily it did not happen with ours, because I don't know, I'm not a strict choreographer, I'm not somebody who's I'm not a control freak, but still they respected my thought process maybe, and it happened. But right now they're all super busy with their own individual artistic journey, and I am super busy with my students. They have grown up enough to dance with us, so whenever we have the need to do the group, yes, all these artists are always ready to come and perform with us. But it is also time we support and bring our students also on stage, and that's what is happening right now. Other than that, I always wanted to do a trio, and which happened with Shruti, Aditya and myself with Abha. I could not think at that particular production as a group production, because I wanted to work around these three important characters only, and students, that is why it worked so well. Yes, ma'am.
In fact, that was my next question on Abha, that you did with the three, your wife Shruti and your student Aditya. You hear me? Kelsita? Okay, so you came out. Yeah, you came out with this beautiful production Abha, which was a grand success. Can you take us through a journey of Abha? Like, how did you, what was the procedure of how did you go through the script, the concept, the music, the choreography? And what do you think was the best part of it that made it such a good success?
Aditya had performed with us in Hara and Punya Krishna and several other productions, and he's not my student, ma'am. He's my Guru Bandhu. He has learned under Lasya Institute in Kerala, then under Kiran Subramaniam sir and Sandhya aunty, and now he's learning under Sudha aunty along with me. So there is a kind of a flow in his dance that has always attracted many rasikas. And with Shruti, me performing for so many years together, and Aditya also performing with Punya, I wanted to come up with the theme Ramayana, and I did not know what to do with Ramayana because it is so overdone, and I knew that it had to start from the scripting. In the script, it had to have something very interesting to hold the audience or to come across as a different take on Ramayana. And we always see, so I must say the reason why I did Abha, one of the most important turning, I think one of the theater, I would not elaborate it, and a theater artist who had very little knowledge about the Indian culture, and also a little bit of, he was from abroad. He had commented so many wrong things about Ramayana. Unfortunately, Shruti could not answer them at that particular point, and it bothered her a lot. She came and had a discussion with her father, and her father went on giving beautiful answers. I must say that was the initiation for the thought process of Abha. From there, I thought, why can't I present the same answers through the dance production? And once I was traveling to Kolkata, I bought this book of Shri Devdutt Patnaik, Sita. I read that also influenced me. and also one video of his, Devdutt Patnaik sir, I watched it on Facebook, where he was explaining how Sita is the most, Sita is stronger than Rama, and she proves that in five different instances in Ramayana, right from lifting the bow much before him, and because she prayed to Lord Shiva that the bow should become as Mount Kailas when Ravana came, and should become like lotus when Rama came. And very interesting take on Ramayana, which I felt like it was like most happy Ramayana or brighter side of Ramayana. That is why I wanted the name Abha, which means brighter side. I believe in only one thing, ma'am. If your intentions are good, everything fall into place. What is your intention as an artist? That is most important thing. Is popular to gain popularity is your intention, you will fall flat. If making money is in your intention, your art will fall flat. Especially with the art forms like Bharatanatyam. Your art, your intention is to create something because you love to create it. Everything will follow you because you are at your best. You are creating something best of you. So people would love to see your best always. They do not come there to compare you with some other artists. They like you as an artist and they want to see your best in all the forms. And everything else follows it. That's what I believe.
Beautifully, beautifully expressed. And I just see that how differently younger generation can put it.
I can
the
hear
same. It's so interesting to see how the younger generation express their views of the older thoughts. You know, this thought has been always told to us, right? Even for me, and I'm sure artists even before me. And the very simple thing they say is, "Yalli Saraswati irtalo, a Lakshmi irala." It's one of the small examples. You should dance for that. And you've said it so beautifully.
If you or Pratiksha can repeat the question.
No, I'm going to tell you the question now. You have successfully trained many students and also have danced with one of the young dancers, I think she's Akshata, on a national platform recently. You presented a duet. So can you tell us, can you tell me what is your training methodology, and also what made you dance with such a young student that on a national platform? Pratiksha? So, just a line to the viewers. Parshvanath is in a remote, like his, the network where he is somewhere close to Belgaum, which is in the outskirts of Belgaum. It doesn't have a very good network, he had expressed to me. But he also has come to a place where there is probably some good network, which goes off and on. I just hope, Parshva, can you hear me? Okay.
So, I can hear you, ma'am, but it's still breaking.
Okay. You have successfully trained many young students. Okay. And recently you danced with a young student, Akshata, on a national platform. So what made you do this? Because generally it's on a national platform. Sometimes even to put our senior students, we are very scared. Okay. And what is your training methodology?
I just heard you said I danced with Akshata recently.
So,
is the question about that?
It's to dance with a young student on a national platform is quite, you know, to take that decision itself is very difficult. So, what made you do this, and what is your training methodology?
Okay, Akshata, I think she is a very rare case, and I think I had to practice a lot to be able to dance with her. And this is the Varanam that I had choreographed for her, for her Arangetram. And I had a very busy schedule, to be very honest, and I had to perform for this national platform, Chembur Fine Arts. And I requested them if I can dance with my student, because I wanted to work with her on this choreography. I had told them I'll be presenting this Varanam. And while practicing with her, I felt, why not she also dance with me, because she's putting so much of effort. And she is somebody who has like all my mannerisms, she tries to catch up. So she dances like me sometimes. So when I watched in the mirror dancing with her, it felt like it was matching very well. And why not give it a try? And the recording came out very well. And I requested the organizers, my student will be performing with me. Please give me this permission. They said, absolutely fine, as far as you are dancing. I said, once you look at me, you'll forget me, you'll watch me. And that was the reality.
So what is your training? What is the methodology that you follow, Parshwa, to imbibe in them that efficiency?
I make sure that the disciplinary way of teaching this classical art form does not hinder their interest. That is very important for me. They constantly have this zeal or the interest in the art form in their heart all the time, irrespective of how beautifully they are dancing. And also, I make sure that they know that dancing nicely does not mean you need more energy or you need more stamina. You can be dancing well with your whatever stamina you have. Instead of holding your hands and legs tight, you have to just hold it in a right position. You have to just hold it right. And that is something we all, not just me, Shruti and Aditya, three of us teach in our dance school. And we all try to put this particular thought in their mind that you are dancing well, and however you are dancing from last 1 year, dancing much better. But the format of the class, it is never ever the same. It keeps on changing. We try to bring as much of variety as possible. We try to bring in Arjun Bharadwaj sir, who talks about Natya Shastra. We try to bring in Rohit for music and related Talam, Vinay sir for Talam, and Preeti Bharadwaj. We introduce many students. We introduce our students to many different genre of art and all the artists. But when it comes to, I think the turning point in our students' life is their either their Arangetram or their exams, because these are the only things which give them ample of time to spend with us. Otherwise, it is just hardly 2 hours, 1 hour in a week. When they think about doing an Arangetram or attend for junior exams, senior exam, they transform into a different artist. Because they stay in our house, they spend so much of time with us, and that is what Gurukula system is all about. You don't come and take a 1 hour session with your, that session name itself is something misleading with your teacher. You need to stay, you need to learn, you need to understand the thought process of the teacher, and it cannot be brought in together in just 1 hour. So that is what happening at the place where I'm staying here right now, ma'am. Hopefully the construction of the physical construction of the Gurukulam will be completed soon with your blessings.
Yeah, I'll surely be there once it's ready. Now, Parshwa, you have collaborated with many dancers abroad with many dance institutions. What is the difference that you find in our regional or national institutions or local institutions in the way they function, in the way they train, or in the way, what is it that makes us local? It's not just that, you know, they are on an international map, but I definitely see there are certain things which make a difference. And now that you are setting up your institute, your Gurukula, what are the things that you see and you wish to, you have absorbed to make our institutions, because we have all the stuff, but something is missing somewhere.
Yep, yes, ma'am.
Can you share your
views?
You
asked me the artist.
Can you share your views?
Mommy, there is a lag, so he will hear you eventually.
Yes,
he'll just hear it a little.
I think if I understood it right, I have collaborated with many artists whom I find interesting and how they inspired me. No? Okay.
You have collaborated with many international institutions and of course artists.
Right.
But these institutions function very differently, and though the Indian dance is from India and we put in a lot of practice and everything, somewhere I see a difference in the way we organize our approach, our attitude in the local or in the regional or national dance institutions compared to international dance institutions. So what are the differences that you have seen and adapt to your Gurukula?
Okay, ma'am. So basically, the idea of this Gurukulam is to provide an atmosphere not only for the students but also for us, where we can stay peacefully and create art, and also inviting other artists and giving them a space where they can come and without any disturbance with the musicians, they can come and stay there and create their art. I mustn't say this, but I feel a lot of us, including me sometimes, we create art for something and not just for creating, you know. We create always something for a performance or for an exam, or for an arangetram. We create, so what happens here is there is this stagnation happens in the thought process, which I do not see happening with the institutions or even the dance companies which work abroad. And also there is huge amount of scope in terms of government grants, and also yes, every single performance that happens abroad, it is ticketed, so they know whatever amount they are putting in, effort they are putting in, they can afford to get it back. Here we haven't heard about a lot of terms like rehearsal conductor or even a studio for practice. We meet together in a small room and we just choreograph and go on stage and perform. Sometimes we have done that as well. So there's lack of, I wouldn't say it's a lack of professionalism, but we are happy with this. You know, we are very happy with this and we enjoy it a lot also. There is no doubt about it. But yes, to create something that would really make a difference in the dance field internationally, the setup needs to change. The support system needs to change, is what I feel. But yes, if I have to create something right now today, I wouldn't sit and wait for somebody else to come and help me. I would like to create it on my own. That is how my approach has been always. I never wanted anything to hold me back. Yes, budget-wise, we always had the constraint. We could not think about lavish setups behind us. So that is why we tried to show everything through our art form, and it worked well with us. But apart from that, no, I never stopped thinking just because there is a financial issue. I must say, Sneha, Matangi, Preeti, all of them have contributed immensely financially when we created Hara. We did not have money to create music. We did not have money to do anything. And that is when we decided, yes, we will not ask for sponsors, but we will ticket the show. And I know that nobody is going to go back saying, no, not worth my money. And nobody did it.
Very good. Even before you made a mark for yourself in the field of Bharatanatyam, you released your DVD Shambho, facilitating dancers across the globe to use your music and the choreography. Now, this is in contrast to our times where even dance scripts or music was not given by the guru to the student. In our times, there was a hold, you know, people never gave us scripts or even music. So what was your objective behind taking this, such a decision? And did you reach the desired result?
I think I wouldn't say I was the pioneer in doing that, ma'am, because Ananya was already doing it. Ananya was already bringing, I think, if I'm not wrong, many audio CDs and not DVDs, not with the visual, of course, but a lot of audio CDs. And I remember Madhurai Murali Dharan sir from Chennai was doing the same thing where he was releasing a lot of CDs. But in most of the DVDs I saw which were in the market, they had this clause, do not use the music or it's copyrighted by so and so. Yeah, I understand that, but it is also very important for the dancers to let them know that yes, you can learn the choreography, you can even perform with the music, because no matter what restrictions we are going to put it, people are going to use it. They are not using it to listen to the music, they are all dancers. And this is something I wanted to do it for so many years, because what I went through as an artist, when I was in Belgaum, I used to dance for film music because there was some swarams in the particular song. Even if it is played in harmonium or not non-Carnatic music song, just because it sounded a little bit close to classical music, my mother used to bring it and my sir used to choreograph, because we never had an access or even thought that yes, we can go to a studio and perform. And for many, many years this happened. And once what happened, a friend of mine had shared an audio for me to listen to it, and I had no idea about all these rules that you should not go through in creating. I'm talking about in early 2000s when I had no idea, and I had choreographed and performed in a temple, and somebody got to know from somewhere, and I had to go through a lot of the scoldings for doing it. So I realized, not just me, there are many, many students who are very talented and they want to dance, but unfortunately they do not have music. I would have continued doing it every single year, but luckily so many people are doing it now. It's not just me. So many people are bringing audio CDs and they are letting people know, yes, use it. You can dance to it. We are releasing it so that you can dance to it. And that, with the result, yes, we had printed close to 1,000 CDs. They were sold out, and also online CDs. We released it online in 2015, and hundreds of them have bought it. And one song which was written by me and composed, Shambho Shankara Shiva, that became viral. Which I never expected.
It's a very good recording and lovely beats, because I remember you gave me one in Dance Jatre when you had a stop. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
So with this, we come to the end of my questions. And now we take questions from the audience and Pratiksha.
I think before we can go to my round of rapid questions, Pash, there are some questions from the viewers, which would you like to take? Okay. Learning Bharatanatyam way back in the 80s, early 90s, in a small town like Karwar, it was also a challenge for us to find a teacher from other cities like Dharwad, Udupi, and then find students to join these classes. So we could start a class. The quality is not so much improved still in these days in smaller towns.
Hutu, he's not there.
Can you hear me, Pash? I think he should be back.
Sorry, viewers. You know, we all have the privilege of sitting at our homes and listening to it. No ticketing. So sometimes we have to accept that all this is a part of the journey, and I'm sure he'll be back. In the meantime that he's back, I want to thank all the speakers who have been with us, including Pashwa, who have spent their valuable time sharing their experiences, their turning points, their challenges, their thought process, their values. And I'm sure this is such an inspiration for all of us, including me. So,
sorry.
Yeah, no problem. So, Pratiksha?
Yes, sorry.
Yeah. So, the first question is, in smaller towns, even today, it's very difficult to find a standard, a good quality of teaching dance. So how could we bring quality classical dance learning to small towns? In brief, the question.
Well, it is changing, I must say. We cannot say the way situation was 20 years back, 30 years back remains the same, because I used to dance on songs like Jungle Mein Mor Nacha Kisne Dekha. Okay, so today the dancers there in Belgaum or smaller towns, they are doing much more standard dance, and I can assure you there are many more talents who dance so beautifully, right from Belgaum, Karwar, Mangalore, Mysore. I have seen so many beautiful dancers. It is definitely changing. How it is changing? Yes, there are so many dancers who have come to Bangalore, gone to Mysore, gone to Chennai, gone to Kalakshetra, gone to Bangalore University and different universities, gone to different gurus, have learned and gone back to their houses, gone back to their villages, gone back to their cities, towns, and they're teaching there. That is what is making difference today. Because every artist, everybody was, you know, concentrated in these major cities of Bangalore and a little bit Mysore and Mangalore. I'm talking only about Bharatanatyam. But right now, if you say, we cannot say that Bangalore is the only place, because good teachers, good gurus are there in Belgaum, good gurus are there in Karwar, Shirsi, everywhere across Karnataka, that as much as I know.
I want to add to this point saying that, see, when Pashwanath was hungry, for some years he got the foundation, a very good foundation. And when it was the right time, his guru told him that move on. And I'm sure if your search is genuine, you have to travel. You cannot wait for everything to come to you. And this shows how hungry you are.
Our next question is, what is your suggestion to young artists about physical fitness? And what is your daily routine workouts to be fit?
This particular question, I wonder why we ask each other, because these are very generic questions like, is it important to be physically fit? Yes, it is important to be healthy, right? And everybody knows how to be healthy. 90% of your health is in your kitchen, so you have to eat well. Everybody knows that you have to exercise, you have to have good sleep. So there is nothing magical suggestions that I'm going to give. Even I'm a normal human being like you, I feel lazy sometimes. I don't dance at all for a couple of days, sometimes a week. But you have to constantly motivate yourself. You have to exercise. If you have to keep yourself fit, not just because you want to be a dancer, but also if you want to enjoy the life, it is very important that you lead a healthy lifestyle. That is very important, number one. And yes, stamina matters. But at the same time, you also should remember there is a lot more to dance, a lot more to this art form other than just the physical form of it. It is not just about how much I can jump or how much I can, how long I can dance, but how much ever long I dance, how I danced is most important than how long I can dance. So without panting, if I can able to dance or just be a little bit more creative, you should, your abhinaya should be good enough. Even if you sit in one place and dance for 1 hour, people should be able to watch you. There you don't need stamina. So it is not just about your physical strength, but also your mental strength. Your healthy mind is also very important. So eat well, sleep well, dance and enjoy. Okay, the dance should give you the enjoyment. That is the whole point of it. Yes.
The next question is, you came up with your dance school only in the year 2010. That was after learning Bharatanatyam for so many years. Why did it take so much of time? What are those things that one needs to keep in mind before starting a dance school? I hope you heard.
I'll be honest with you, the reason I started dance class for money, for my financial stability. It's not like I did not enjoy teaching. But now, of course, I love teaching, but the main reason, the priority was to sustain. Because if there was no financial support, it was difficult to survive in Bangalore. And without being in Bangalore, I could not continue dancing. That was given. So one should know that you are not going to do any injustice to the art form by becoming a teacher. And yes, earning is one part of it, but also I knew that I had learned enough to teach at least small kids what they want. And with the students, yes, I have grown up today as a teacher. Yes, just because I said this, don't finish your junior exam and become teachers. Spend a little bit more time learning the art form. Spend more time with your teachers. Understand them what to do. And more experience, of course, it is good for you. More than what to do, you should know what not to do in this art field, I must say.
Yeah. I think the next question we have been discussing about, but still, because a viewer is asking, do you see Bharatanatyam evolving in its form and content in any way? Of course, in many ways. Let us hear from you. Telling more contemporary stories and the like.
Bharatanatyam has always been contemporary. That is something we must understand why I'm saying this. Contemporary does not mean only when you take the issues of contemporary, but I'm talking about the emotions which are universal and they are timeless. Emotions are never time bound. Whatever a human being felt or a 40-year man felt 100 years back, can be the same thing today when he looks at a woman or when he is sad. So the emotions are always contemporary. But in terms of concepts, if you think we are not addressing the concept directly, yes, we have the tendency of telling everything with lot of masala. That is what makes it, you know, interesting. I cannot go and tell you, okay, plant the tree. That will be just 1 minute dance composition. If I have to interest you in planting the tree, I have to do a composition like Abha. How Sita enjoyed this forest. Now Sita does not have a forest for herself. What she will do? A composition which inspires you indirectly and also gives my message hidden but very effectively. That is what the kind of approach I have. I would never go and tell you directly. If I have to do that, I can SMS you or just call you and tell you, or just promote it on the TV. But as an artist, through my art, if I want to tell something, the bhavam, the expressions should reach out to you more than just the communication, because dance is just not about conveying the lyrics. It is more than communicating the words. It is about communicating my thought process. And definitely dance, Bharatanatyam, is contemporary. And yes, we can do anything with the medium of Bharatanatyam, but we also should know why we want to do it. To prove that Bharatanatyam can do contemporary themes, yes, it is given, it is understood. It is not that we have to prove anything. I don't have to prove it. If you give me any particular theme, through the medium of my vocabulary, I can present it. But why am I supposed to do it? That I should be convinced about.
The next question is, when can a dancer understand that he or she can become a guru?
I mean, if I have to say it very philosophically, whenever the student arrives, the guru is ready, something like that. But I suggest every single person to not to become a guru, it's a huge word, to teach. You must teach. When you teach as a senior student to a junior student, or just a couple of your relatives, when I was very young, I used to teach my neighbors. I used to call them, and when they used to call me to play, I used to tell them, come, let us play the game of dance class today. And I used to teach them a couple of adabs. I was always interested in making them do. And whenever you teach, you become aware of what not to do, like how you have to hold your hands, how they are doing it, and how it will look if you put more time here in this choreography. All these things are possible only when you teach. Or teach or choreograph on somebody. So I must say, if you have done your senior exam or Vidwat exam, start teaching adavos, start teaching simple compositions to your whoever your students are, new students. And trust me, it is never going to be easy unless you already have 10-20 students, because I have taught one student for almost 6 months. Then next 6 months I have taught two students. This is, I'm talking of after opening my dance school and performing in a temple and announcing that I am starting my dance school, please come and join. One student joined and for 6 months. Then after 1 month, one more year, we had more students. But don't lose hope. You all must teach, not just for the money, not because you want to earn livelihood, but to grow as an artist, I think you must teach.
We will just take one last question from the audience before we go to the rapid round. Do you see a transformation happening in dance in this very new virtual world? Because this is being strange and an altogether new subject to many of us. So do you see a transformation happening in the new virtual world to dance?
It wasn't clear for me, Pratiksha. Could you repeat the question, please?
Yeah. Do you see a transformation happening in the world of dance due to this virtual media?
Yes, definitely. I don't think I would have ever attended this kind of interview ever virtually if not for this situation. And the virtual version of the art form has changed in different levels. In teaching as well, we record a dance school classroom, 1 hour dance class, and we send it to our students, which they attend in their class. Then they attend our live class. Because of all these network issues, they get very well made video, they learn the choreography. In terms of performances, it is very tricky, I must say. So many productions I have seen which would have looked rather dull if I had seen them live, but in virtual presentation of them, the usage of location, the usage of camera has really, really enhanced those productions that I have seen. A couple of them I can remember of. The lighting and the way the camera moves and all these things are possible only when it is done virtually. And we could see this shift even before the pandemic. ABHA was telecasted live and more audience watched it online than in the auditorium when we premiered it. So the virtual performance can definitely not be equivalent to the live presentation, but some places it can be positively different. I hope this is not the permanent setup. That is the first prayer I'm going to do to the Lord, and hopefully this will change very soon.
Thanks, Pash. So now we come to my rapid round of questions. Okay, so the first one is, what would Pashvanath in his childhood days do?
Sorry.
Can you hear me?
Now it's better.
What would Pashvanath in his childhood days do with all the free time in hand?
I did not have free time. My mom kept me busy. I was a very naughty child. I think that was the reason why she kept me busy. If I can elaborate it, my daily timetable for almost 10 years. Morning 6 to 8, I had karate. 8 to 9, I had painting class. And 9, I had my school. And immediately, I had to rush to my dance class. And I had a couple of other things before. I had swimming from night 8 o'clock to 10:30. That was my swimming time, professional swimming, I mean. So this was, I did not have free time. She did not want me to think about anything to be naughty. I don't know why she kept me so busy, but I'm thankful to her. Today I'm whatever I am because of her.
Yeah, that sounds a little. That sounds a little like my mother during my vacation, summer holidays. Always jam-packed, never let
me do. No, that was my life.
I can imagine. Your favorite way of relaxation, if at all, you get to do so then?
I relax a lot. My life is perfectly like how you work a lot in your childhood and you can relax. I am having a very relaxful time at this time. I create new choreographies, I work for my dance school, whatever the work is required, and I am very much relaxed. There are a lot of days I just take off, and the place where Gurukulam is being built, it is surrounded by amazing natural beauty. I just go there and meditate.
Yeah, we can see that on your Instagram stories.
Pratiksha, so like him, you are also relaxing a lot. Enjoy.
Okay. What was that distinctive quality of Sudha Rani Raghupati aunty that made you seek her mentorship at this phase of your artistic journey?
I think her humbleness, her humility as an artist. She did not recognize me as somebody who is almost 40 years younger to her. 30 years younger to her, she looked at me as an artist. And the first time when I met her after my music academy performance, I remember very clearly how she just told me, come from next month whenever you can. I just want to sit and work with you on the compositions. And it just happened that way. And I just requested her if I can come this month. She said, sure, why not? Next week onwards, let us start your class. There was, I did not have time to think about, oh, should I go here, should I go? It just happened.
Puttu, 1 minute, Puttu, I missed on it because of the thing. So he said that after the show in Music Academy?
Yeah.
Can you?
Yes, ma'am.
After that, she only invited you?
After Music Academy performance, I went to her house with a couple of others. And there I went and request, I told her, right now, I want to learn. And she had not come to the performance. She had missed my performance. And her son was, Anyanna was going on praising me in front of me, how good I was that day. And I danced a little bit in front of her. And that is how our class started.
Getting the same set of musicians repeatedly is quite a challenge. So how do you manage to do it?
I don't know how do I manage to do it. I think I'm just lucky that I always get the same artists to work with me, because it is a blessing. Especially on those days when you don't get time to practice, they know what we are going to do on stage, and we know they are going to cover it up. If we are going to expand the Sancharis, we are very lucky to have Harsha Anna creating music for us, creating rhythmic sections for us for so long. Jairam sir, Mahesh sir, and Rohit, Shrikant Anna, and I should not name, because every single artist whom I have been working with are amazing people. And I must say we are very lucky that we get to work with them again and again.
Okay. So now, Parsh, you have to choose between the following. And quickly.
Okay.
Performing or teaching?
Performing.
Learning or choreographing?
Learning.
Bindu or Mallika?
That's very difficult.
Time. Okay, so Aramandi or memes?
Memes on Aramandi.
And I still didn't get my answer for my previous question. Bindu or Mallika?
No, I do not choose between my students.
Okay. Considering you have a huge fan base, how do you manage to stay safe without invoking the wrath of your wife?
There is a saying in Kannada, Urge bitiro goli basava. They leave one particular ox to the street. That is considered as the ox of the basava of the town. So that is how she has left me. I'm an artist. I'm a free soul. I am a basava. And all my devotees, all my friends, all my family are always there.
No, I think I need to cross.
They're just not my... I would not call them as fans. That is a very weird word for me. All my friends, supporters, and they're all supporters of the entire Punya Dance Company, I must say. I have always received a positive response for the entire team. Shruti, Aditya, or Sneha, Vatangi, Preeti, everybody. As a team, we have always received. Or whenever even I have performed solo, I have received support for the entire team, including the musicians. They understand the value of it. So it doesn't really make any difference to me.
But I'm going to cross-verify this with Shruti. Okay. Now, sing a few lines from your most favorite romantic song for Shruti now, for your wife.
Yo, after 10 years of marriage, it is a little difficult, but I will try. This is for everyone out there.
Oh, you're inviting trouble,
with
Parsh.
Beautiful eyes. No. This is for everyone out there with beautiful eyes for dance, beautiful eyes for art and aesthetics. तेरी आंखों के सिवा दुनिया में रखा क्या है, ये उठे सुबह चले, ये झुके शाम ढले, मेरा जीना मेरा मरना इन्हीं पलकों के तले, तेरी आंखों के सिवा दुनिया में रखा क्या है।
Pashwanath, I want you to sing one particularly for your wife, Shruti.
Okay.
Because we keep pulling her leg. I don't know in which muhurtam they named her Shruti. She's horrible in singing.
She no, no, it. You're not. And you have still not got it.
Very few people know it and acknowledge it, you know.
She was named Shruti.
Really bad. But one thing I really appreciate that she keeps trying. She has joined music class in these times and she's been learning. For Shruti. It is hard. रहना बीते जाए शाम न, आई कैन इमेजिन हर डूइंग अभिनय टू दिस, शाम न रहना बीते जाए निंदिया न रहना बीते जाए शाम न आए रहना बीते जाए।
I'm so happy that your young generation still live on the old romantic songs of our times.
Ma'am, I must correct you here. I must correct you. Sorry, but you're calling me young, but I'm not so young.
Younger than
I
me.
I feel really good. I feel really good you're calling me young. I am almost 40 years, so I do not know
Pashwa, that you're considered younger than me, right?
Yes, no, ma'am. You are right. Okay. I mean, I'm born and brought up in Belgaum, which is heavily influenced by Bollywood and Mumbai border of Maharashtra. So these songs we have grown up with. Yes.
And Pash, I feel she was named Shruti rightly because somebody knew she would get a husband who will make up for all the shortcomings she had with music, who could sing well for her. Okay. Now our next question. How does it feel to be a young and a busy father to a naughty son like Vidraj?
He is not naughty. He is a very easy child. He comes across as very naughty, but he is somebody very calm. And again, thank you so much for calling me young again. But I think, yes, that was a turning point as an artist in my life when I became father. Also, Vidraj, the name itself says somebody who is devoid of all the attachments, worldly attachments. And right now, at least, touchwood, he is somebody who, when we go to a shop and I ask him, "Do you want this?" Like, no, why? We have already at home. So he's somebody who does not want anything. He's a very calm child. He's very easy to handle. Most of the times we just drop him in our in-laws' house or my parents' house and we go for our performances and tours and travels. He hardly has come with us now, at least from last 4-5 years. When he was close to 1 year, one and a half years, he has traveled a lot with me. I was traveling alone, and in flight he has traveled with me to Mumbai, he has traveled with me to Delhi alone, and he has watched me perform where I had to go. I've taken him alone a lot of times. So he's a very, very easy child. He's been. I think that face he puts up for the camera, whenever he talks over the camera, he comes across a very naughty child, but he's not.
Okay. Now, you're known for your wittiness and dry humor. So use both of these talents and share your message to young dancers.
I'm nobody to give message to younger dancers, because I can see them doing amazing work. They are doing much. I think this is the these are the actual words of Minal Prabhu aunty. She always tells how the next generation will be always better than you. Remember that, and you need to accept it. I always think the next generation artists are more hardworking. I can see it. And yes, the older generation feels that the younger generation is deviating here and there. No, it is just that they are trying out something, or they're experimenting with their art form. That's absolutely fine. But the passion that I see in them, if it is guided well by the senior artists, I think it can do magic. So there is no message. Continue your passion. In a witty way, if I have to say, message, it is very big, it's very serious. I don't know how to make it comical.
Bindu says, keep dancing and performing and smiling.
Thank you. Now we come to the last question of my round. One message to your mother.
I could not hear that, sorry.
A message to your mother.
Message to my mother. Oh my God. I just spoke to her before the session. She's somebody very, very special. I know each and every mother is special, and what she's made of, I have no idea, because even at this age, she is more energetic, touchwood, than me or anybody that I know. She is 60 plus now, and at the age of 54, she started learning dance. Bharatanatyam under my Ravindra Sharma sir, and she started her own dance class. She teaches young students, and her students dance brilliantly. She makes them perform, and she keeps herself busy so much. Only message to her is, never stop doing this, what you love the most, and that is what makes you what you are. Yeah, she knows it, that I keep telling her all the time that you are what you are because of your passion. And she's a very passionate woman. Yeah.
I think watching you dance was her turning point, that you inspired her. Huh. At one point, she inspired you.
Definitely.
I think the session will be complete only when you perform probably glimpses of your favorite piece for our viewers. I think we would like to conclude this session with your dance. And in the meantime, you prepare for it with the music. I would like to invite my mother, Vaijayanti Kashi, to please give the vote of thanks. Deliver the vote of thanks, rather.
I thank all of you. Some of you who are watching the live sessions, and some of you who are following it up after you had the time. I truly feel that inspirations are very important in every phase of your life. And people who inspire need not necessarily be elder to us. Anybody, your inspiration can come from anywhere. And the Turning Point series was meant that, considering the situation that we are all passing through, that these inspiration and noble thoughts from everywhere can make a difference. We truly hope that you have enjoyed this series, the first session of Turning Point. And today is the last day of our Turning Point first series. And I would like to profoundly thank all the speakers who have been with us and spent their valuable time, their valuable messages through us. And this would have not been possible without the support of Pratiksha, my daughter and disciple, because all the technical things, posters, and she in another area, I in another area, we managed it. And I also thank Ashwini for having supported us, and all of you. As one of our speakers said, nothing is possible without a good team. And if the team is like a family, what we achieve will not only do good for each one of us, but to the entire society. So thank you. As we end this first series of Turning Point with Parshvanath, we hope to come back with new ideas and new thoughts. Thank you, Pratiksha, and thank you, Ashwini, and thank you, all the viewers and my speakers.
I think we lost connectivity with Parsh, so he should...
In the meantime, someday everything will make perfect sense. So for now, laugh at the confusion, smile through the tears, and keep reminding yourself that everything happens for a reason. India is closed for renovation. The grand opening, reopening is soon to happen.
So I'm presenting a composition on Lord Ganesha, which we had recently choreographed for our students. Gajamukhane Siddhi Dayakane Bandi Peshar. Jai 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 Jai
Thank you, Parshva. That was, thank you. And that was a grand end to the last day of our first series of Turning Point. On the note that youngsters have a new vision, and as Parshvanath said, youngsters have a lot more to give. To get it in the right time, the right support, the right encouragement, and the right opportunities. In spite of the not very good network, you've taken time, and we are really happy that you joined, you made it for this session. Thank you. And good luck in the...
Thank you so much for having me for this session, ma'am. Thank you so much for making me part of this. I really feel privileged. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Good night.